previous video, I just missed a small thing, which is actually not small, which is pretty big. So I'll just cover it up in this video. It's like fine amount per day and book acquisition limit on the top of the library book manager column. So let's click on fine amount per day. So over here I can actually edit the fine amount and put it whatever I feel like. Let it be 10 rupees or sorry, there's some problem over there. Yeah, the problem is actually as of now the system is allowing me to change it to only a single digit value, because this was the requirement of the client, wherein they will not exceed the fee amount more than 9 rupees. So that is the entire fee amount is less than 10 rupees. So that is there. So I was only able to change it to 9 rupees from 2 rupees. If we need like more fees, like 100 rupees a fine or 50 rupees a fine, so this option can be actually enabled into the system. So this is as of now enabled for a single digit edit, which is basically from 1 to 9 you can edit over here. So anyways, that's fine. We can actually, based on requirement to requirement, we can update that. We can make it 100 digit, 1000 digit, or whatever the university or the college actually wants. So let's look into the book acquisition limit. Over here, the book acquisition is divided under various categories of borrowers, which we will get to know in the borrower management system. There is a major category, there is a degree pass, there is a HS category, there is a teaching staff category, and there is a non-teaching staff category. So this actually signifies the number of books that can be actually issued to a particular member, to a particular borrower. So let's say if I am giving 3 books in the major category, so the borrowers who fall under major category will only be able to borrow 3 books from the library at a particular point of time. And if for teaching staff, we have always like, you know, the members of the library or the faculty members can always go and take up 10 books. You can always keep it high. It's up to case to case basis. So if you need more categories in this, that can also be added into the system with an external plugin, which gives you the access of creating more number of categories over here. So this is pretty cool and very important, because this will actually keep a hold on the issuing capacity of the operator as well as the receiving capacity of the borrowers. So this is important. So anyways, I just save my changes. I can click here again just to see whether my change is done. So my change has been done over here. So this is great. So yeah, now let's go to add books. So I click on add books and I get all these fields for the book, which are like, there are many as well: book title, author name, accession number, call number, volume edition, publication year, publication name, ISBN number, price of the book, the kind of language for the book. So over there, there are pre-filled languages for Indian languages. Then there is categories, whether it falls under autobiographies, biographies, description is there. So if I click on auto fill, few of the fields will be automatically filled up for you to overwrite over them. This makes easier for typing. So book title, anything like accession number can be, this is where the integration plugin actually works. If I am using a barcode scanner, then automatically I can scan the barcode and this accession number will automatically appear in this field from the book barcode information. So this option is available. It can be integrated, and also we can show it as a demo.